Good evening everyone and welcome back to our channel. I am Twinkle Quadra from IME Law College and currently a legal intern at Lexis & Company, and today the topic that I am going to start is wrongful restraint and wrongful confinement. So according to our constitution, it is the right of every person in this country to move freely. But there are some people that confines the other one and does the offense of wrongful confinement and wrongful restraint. And in this video, I will discuss through IPC sections that what is the punishment and what is exactly wrongful confinement and as well as wrongful restraint. So let's just get started. So there is section 339 that deals with wrongful restraint. And let's just read the Bare Act. It says, whoever voluntarily obstruct any person so as to prevent that person from proceeding in any direction in which that person has a right to proceed is said wrongfully to restrain that person. It means that if someone is obstructing your path and he is not allowing you to go from that path, that means that person is liable for wrongful restraint. For example, there is four direction and A has stopped B from going through first direction, but B has right to go from any other three directions. So if he will restrain his first direction, then also he is liable for wrongful restrainment. But here the condition applied, or you can say there is an exception, that if someone is doing this in good faith, then this will not be under wrongful restraint. As example, if there is a farm of A and A is obstructing that B from coming to this way, so he has every right to do that because the farm belongs to A. Now let's come to section 340. It says wrongful confinement. The bare language is whoever wrongfully restrain any person in such a manner as to prevent that person from proceeding beyond certain circumscribing limit is said to wrongfully confine that person. So here in wrongful confinement also the person is doing the restrainment of that person, but there is a circumscribing limit. It means that there all the four direction has been closed by that person. There is no direction through which the person has the right to move. For example, there is a room and in that room A just locked B and said you cannot come outside, otherwise I will kill you. In that case he will be liable for wrongful confinement. And also this wrongful confinement can be physically, like a room or any other hall etc., but it could be mentally as well. For example, A draws a circle on the road and says B that if you will cross this circle I will kill you immediately. So in that case B is mentally restrained and he is mentally confined in that particular circle. So this was about wrongful restraint and wrongful confinement. Let's come to the punishment. 341 says punishment for wrongful restraint, it is of 1 month plus fine, which can be exceed to 500, or it could be both. And 342 says punishment for wrongful confinement, it is of 1 year plus fine, and fine could be exceed to 1,000 rupees, or both. 343 says wrongful confinement for 3 or more days. So if someone confines any other person for 3 or more days, then that person will be liable for 2 years of imprisonment plus both, and the imprisonment could be of either description. And 344 section says wrongful confinement for 10 or more days. It means that if someone confines any other person for 10 or more than 10 days, then he will be liable for imprisonment of 3 years plus fine. And the imprisonment can be of either description. Now 345 says wrongful confinement of person for whose liberation a writ has been issued. It means that if the court has issued the writ and has said that leave that person, and but the other person is not leaving after that writ has been issued by the court, then he will be liable for 2 years of 2 years of imprisonment, and also for the offense of confinement. So for example, if someone has confined a person for 12 days, right, now the writ has been issued by the court but he is not leaving that person, then he will be liable under section 344, that is more than 10 days, and he will be liable for 3 years plus he will be liable for 345 and he will be liable for 2 more years. So total there will be 5 years of imprisonment. Now 346 says wrongful confinement in secret. If someone confines some other person in secret so that the person concerned about that that person doesn't know, or any police officer doesn't know, or that he chooses that place that is unknown to all, in that case he will be liable for 2 years of imprisonment and also for any other offense that will be committed by him. So for example, if A has confined B in the remote area, then police and the relatives of B are not able to find him, then A will be liable for 2 years and also for the other offenses that he will do under that confinement. And 347 says wrongful confinement to extort property or constrain to illegal act. It means that if someone has confined the other person for the purpose of extortion or for any illegal act, or he is forcing the other person for doing that illegal act, then that person will be liable for 3 years of imprisonment plus fine. And imprisonment can be of either description. Last section for wrongful confinement and wrongful restraint is that 348, wrongful confinement to extort confession or compel restoration of property. It means that if someone has confined you and is forcing you to give your this confession, or he is saying that to restore your property in his name or any other person's name, in that case the person will be liable for 3 years plus fine. And for example, if a policeman has confined you and he is forcing to give your confession, and he is forcing you to say that you have did this offense, and he is just forcing you, then that police officer will also be under imprisonment of 3 years of 3 years and fine. So that's it for today's video. I hope you liked it, and also keep liking, keep sharing, and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.